How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can use ExpressVPN on the desktop. Whether you're on Mac or Windows, you're going to be able to use this as a reference for just everything you need to learn about ExpressVPN. Now, thankfully, this will be a short video because ExpressVPN is that easy to use. So it can be as easy, you know, once you install your VPN and you pretty much have your credentials in there, all you have to do is click the on button and you are good to go. It's really as simple as that. But of course, you're not here because you know, obviously it's very self-explanatory when it comes to using the on and off button, obviously. And let me just show you guys. I am connected to Miami, so it shows that my IP address is, it shows as if I'm in Miami. But I'll use this later. This is just a way for you to confirm that you are connected to the correct IP address. So let's just turn this off. Now, it's very simple with regards to using ExpressVPN. By the way, if you're interested in learning more about ExpressVPN, you'll find a review, full review down below if you'd like to learn more about the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. And you'll also find a little discount that'll give you a slight price drop to help you save a little bit more cash, get you 3 extra months. So you want to go to the locations right here, and this is where you will find all of the servers that you're looking for. So recently I was on the American servers, and that's why I was there. But, you know, you can look at the recommended. It'll give you a bunch of recommended servers based on your location. And you can view all the servers based on continents. You know, they're sorted by continent. So, you know, all the European, you have over 3,000 servers in 94 countries. And that is way over the industry standard. 94 countries is a massive number. So, you know, some Middle Eastern servers here and there, lots of American and South American servers, lots and lots of Asian servers, which is usually not really that common with VPNs. So you'll find plenty of those. And obviously lots of European servers, which all VPNs have in common, I would say. Okay, so that'll be it for the locations list. You have a speed test. Now, the speed test feature will save you a lot of time. It'll kind of let you know which servers are the best without having to test them out individually. So yeah, this is a very nice feature that honestly you don't see in a lot of VPNs. Okay, and then you have your options. And this is where you're going to just notice that you don't really have much to mess with here. The user interface is very simple with ExpressVPN and it's very straightforward. All you need to know, really. Now, you have a couple of startup options here, but you're only going to mess with two tabs here. That'll be the general tab and the protocol tab. And you can always keep your option on automatic here. You don't ever have to change that. But if you're looking for, let's say, the fastest speeds at all times, you can just use lightweight or you can keep it on automatic. I generally prefer to keep it on lightweight. Now, with the general tab here, you need to know that the kill switch and split tunneling are the only two features that are available in ExpressVPN. ExpressVPN is a very bread and butter type of VPN. It's supposed to be as easy as possible to use. It's just a plug and play VPN. And it does the job very efficiently and very well. So all you need to know is that the kill switch will cut your internet traffic if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. And this will make sure that you're only going to be connected to the internet only when you're secured by the VPN. Otherwise, the VPN will cut your internet connection, preventing any leaks. And it's just a good security measure, especially if you want to make sure that you don't get any of your information leaked to the ISP or internet service provider. Now, split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So you can choose to encrypt certain applications, such as maybe your browser or your torrenting client or any other application that you can add through this button right here, while the rest of your connection is exempt from the VPN tunnel, essentially. And you can do it the other way around, where you can have selected applications not use the VPN while the rest of your connection is using the VPN. So this is a very useful way for people. Let's say you want to use Netflix, you want to change your region to unblock Netflix, but you don't want the entirety of your connection to use the VPN, right? So you can use split tunneling for that. And with regards to protocols, again, there's nothing you want to mess with here. You can just keep it on automatic and you're good to go. Now you've got your browsers here and shortcuts. Once you turn on the VPN, you'll notice that these shortcuts will show up here. So you can set up specific shortcuts, you know, be it Netflix, Amazon, whatever it is. So, you know, you can just add, let's say, a website link, right? And we can do netflix.com add shortcut. There we go. I don't have to do the www dot thing. So we're good. And you'll notice that when I turn on the VPN, it'll show up right here. And it's just a nice way to kind of set up shortcuts so that you can just click it right away. Okay. And in advanced, there's nothing you want to mess with here. Don't touch anything. Okay. You always want to keep this on. You want to keep this on as well to maximize the performance. And then you have the sharing crash reports, which you can opt out of if you'd like, but this will help ExpressVPN improve their service. And that's pretty much it. That's how you use ExpressVPN. It's as simple as that. Okay. Let's click okay. I don't need the network lock and I don't need split tunneling. So this is going to click okay. Let's say I'm trying to unblock Netflix US. So let's go to, or Netflix UK for that matter. I did connect to the US server here. So for a change, let's just connect to the UK server, for example, and go to United Kingdom and pick one of these. Let's just go with Docklands, for example. And I can either click and then turn on the VPN or just double click. And we are good to go. And the moment I connect, I'm just bringing up this IP finder to show you that we are indeed connected to the correct server. And check this out. So Netflix just showed up right away. So you can just click on one of these and it'll take you straight to the websites, which is very convenient. Now I'll just go ahead and refresh and it should show that I am in the UK. And this is how you can make sure that you are connected indeed to the correct server. So that's pretty much how you can use ExpressVPN. It doesn't get any simpler than this. It's made to be as easy to use as possible, even if you've never ever touched a VPN in your life. So if you guys are interested in ExpressVPN, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below. And if you'd like to learn more about Express, you'll also find a full review in the description. Besides that, keep in mind that you do get a 30-day money-back guarantee no matter which plan you decide to go for. So it's very risk-free. It's a hassle-free money-back guarantee, and they won't really bother you. They'll ask you a question or two, and you're good to go. They'll refund you within 3 to 4 business days, so you can try it out very risk-free. And they do have 24/7 live chat support to help you with everything. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.